Okay, we're gonna see how this camera does. It ran out of juice at that meeting. Oh, I think I shouldn't be talking because it's on. Oops.
Recording stopped. Recording in progress.
Well, the thing that's been going on is that the board of works gets their call for order.
At the pledge of allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Yes.
Susan Kimbrough.
Present.
Brianna Maxwell. And Anita Wolf.
Present. The minutes of the February 6th meeting are presented for review and revisions and corrections.
Motion to approve the minutes.
Without objection, that's approved. Next order of business are the review of claims for the February 21st meeting totaling $286,375.82. Is there a motion to approve the claims?
So moved.
I'm by the second. Any discussion? First, is it in here or is it left?
No, it's all right. Nope.
All those federal exceptional funds are $286,375.82. Signify by saying aye.
Aye.
If I am aye, motion carries. We have two guests tonight. Mike Fincher from the ZBA for Carroll County has asked to speak to the board. Mike?
Good evening, Mayor and Mr. Karen. This is just a picture of what the county is looking to do. The next one here. The county's getting ready to go into a major upgrade into the camera system that we have at the courthouse. With that, what we're looking to do is place four cameras on the exterior of the building and actually off of the courthouse grounds. And we would like to use four of the light poles that the city has around the courthouse. And they would be facing back, and it's the cameras that are there, that is the camera that they would be using to place back their IP address or wireless, so it would run back to us. I know the flag poles are black, and these are white-based cameras. I can check and see if we can get the house and it's changed on us.
Have you checked with Aaron Lyons?
I haven't talked to Aaron yet because I didn't want to start moving further and further until I got at least an okay from the...
Sort of down that
rabbit hole? Yep. Power usage is very minimal, and that everybody that's used them in other locations, they see no change in any extra additional electrical power usage in that. But if there is, there's always something that we could discuss in the future. You know, I can't make promises.
Right.
I can be your liaison.
I'm just not sure how easy it is to wire in with those poles.
Our vendor has done it on other poles.
Like
he
that.
Just needs power. And that, so, and I know there's certain poles that have power and the ones that don't have the power that we need. So. I can reach out to Aaron and talk to him if you want me to.
Yeah, what is the timeline on this one?
They've already ordered the equipment, and if you guys turn me down, then I'm going to go start talking to business owners and seeing if I can get them off.
Certainly, if it's feasible, I think we just need to first check whether. I know we had issues with trying to get power to other things off of those poles, so, and how it would get mounted. Without damaging the poles.
Okay. I don't, the vendor's going to be up again on Thursday, because we're going to be looking at interior on a mountain, some additional cameras. So I'll talk to him then, and I'll get with him tomorrow, and if he's available on Thursday, maybe I'll give him a shout and have him come over, and the three of us can have a discussion.
Yeah, that'd be great. If they have them in black housing, that would be preferable, or can it be painted?
Right.
So those would be a couple of questions, but what are your thoughts, Spencer?
I don't have an issue with it. You said there's four?
There's four. There'll be one on each side.
And obviously, we want to make sure that, you know, our utility poles, when they, these are installed, they're going to be damaged, so we make sure they're covered under the rubber agreement we have.
And then, do you see any issues?
I doubt that. I can't imagine if there's no electricity used. Our cameras do.
It's very minimal. The use of the draw, the electricity is very minimal.
So will they be pointed towards the?
They'll be pointed towards the courthouse.
Are there any cameras on businesses now?
No. All the cameras that we have for perimeter coverage are the ones that you see mounted on the courthouse. We're just trying to improve that and build on our security plan. We're trying to move forward, and this is one of the smallest, easiest step.
These cameras are going to be able to go to white screen, and I'm going to be able to place it in front of the courthouse on each street, just the courthouse, and then just the sidewalk coming up to the courthouse and
the streets. They are zoomable, so we can back them up and move them around, and they are IR and start off also. The IR goes up to 3,200 feet, and then the starlight depends on how well the moon and everything else is going.
Chief, you came in here back there. Do you have any questions? Or?
No, it sounds like I don't have any objections or anything, but that something we can maybe down the road even tie into or add some more cameras to get some more security through the downtown. Is it something that's a system that's we can build on?
So this one, the current system that we have is a 4 megapixel, and we can't build any more. Okay. So any additional cameras that we're going to have, we have to get a bigger system in. So we can add more cameras, and we're going to make. So when we had that woman who was building at Washington Street here, and we couldn't zoom in enough with these new cameras, I thought I could have read the guy's letter and not straight. Okay. And we could have figured out who it was. Yeah.
That would be something that would be advantageous as far as the business and something we could add on to it and have more coverage.
Oh, yeah. We can definitely build on those. Most definitely.
And because the camera system is utilized by both county and city.
Correct.
I just wanted to add, Mike and I are on the security for the courthouse committee, and right now the going in and exiting the polling location, there's no camera coverage. So if there were to be an incident in or at the polling location, there's no security at all. So just
with the new system coming in, is there going to be other cameras there as well?
We're adding cameras along there, and then there will be a camera pointing that direction from the west side.
Yep.
ASAP will be.
I make a motion that we approve the use of the poles and that. As long as it's completely insulated and the ash will revisit the electricity that we need.
And you could.
The mounting and the.
That table will, I can tell you that table.
If we can't paint it, I could take it to move over some of that.
Vinyl bib or something like that, the plastic covers.
Plastic cover, vinyl wrap.
Yeah.
I mean, there's a bunch of different things. I'm pretty sure we can change the color on here. I'll make sure it's aesthetically pleasing. I dealt with generals for many years. I know them.
I guess I have the motion on.
Nothing like that, yeah. Those are very cool.
So you'll get with Aaron and anyone else on Thursday, but you'll.
Yeah, when the vendor gets here, I'll get with Aaron and then if you need me to come back to the next Board of Works meeting and once we get it all hashed out, I'll let you guys know most definitely.
Next thing.
We just, we need to have the Carroll County Chamber of Commerce for the annual dues. The Madison from the chamber is here tonight. He's kind of updated us on what they've been doing. And I think we've got the program, so we can send your businesses to you.
Yes, we do. As Mayor said, my name is Madison Kaufman. I am the membership and engagement manager at the Carroll County Chamber of Commerce. I have been there since the end of August, so I am a new employee that they have hired to have. So, yeah, we are coming and asking about your guys' membership dues for the year. You, for the last few years, we have been at the platinum level, and we greatly appreciate it, and thank you for doing that. And so I have included the membership benefits sheet that, and it also has the why join the chamber. It has some information about what we help the businesses do in our community as well. And as of right now, we checked today, we have 213 chamber members in Carroll County and 111 are in Delphi. So 52.1% of our members list Delphi as their location. So that also includes some of the country businesses as well. So it's just kind of nice having that. We do have a program starting soon in April called our Biz Excel program. It covers multiple things that Biz Excel, which I have given you guys that page as well. So we have business next level business planning and management classes. Registration is now open and those will start the beginning of April. So they're five different weeks and for 3 hours. So we have had a couple of classes already and this one's about to start. So that's been really exciting. Surf Safe, we do those classes. We actually have a class tomorrow and it has about 12 participants. So that will be taking place at the chamber office all day tomorrow. Another topic I did want to hit on is we have a revolving loan. We were given $92,000 USDA grant funds for this loan. We've already had three loans and one is actually paid off, and so the funds have gone back into that revolving loan. And we actually have one loan application still pending for a Delphi business. So it's really exciting about that. And our loans are 3% for 5-year fixed income interest. And so we are also applying within the next couple weeks to get more funds for that. So we give those to the businesses to help the business plans. And a lot of times we do try and have those people do our next level classes, so it helps their business plan a little bit more. So that's a little bit about the program, but I did want to bring attention to our calendar of events. So we have multiple events planned for the year. that we have for our members, and there are different workshops that we have, trainings, luncheons. So we have a Canva workshop next week to help with graphics and help businesses create flyers as well. We have a social media coming up March 18th, Saturday. We have Third House coming up, which that is free and open for the public. But I did want to bring to your guys' attention the April 14th State of the City, County, and Luncheons. And we would like to invite you all to come for that. So we are going to be having a catered lunch that day. So, yeah, just a lot of things going on this year. We're super excited, and we greatly appreciate your guys' partnership. Do you have any questions for me?
Any questions? The council did approve in our budget to have $30,000 as a revolving loan.
Yes.
Done by businesses, and I think we're still working through the details on
okay.
that.
Yeah.
So we hope to get that up and running.
Yeah, we'd be happy to help with that.
The same review process and so forth that you are.
Yeah.
But it's the dark county right now, so.
Okay. Yeah, just let us know. We'd be happy to do that. It's seen great progress so far, and we're excited to help as many businesses as we can in the community.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
Any questions? Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Appreciate it. So next on the agenda is the 402 South Washington. Do you want to go to the grounds available as well?
Yes.
Yeah, that's what it's probably referred to. So we'll postpone that until March 6th. Then under new business, we have a scope of work from Baker Tilly for a wastewater project. Including a rate study, which they have already completed. This document was originally submitted to us, I think, last year, and the doctors in January said that it never got signed, apparently. So the money for this comes out of, the total range is for $90,000, which is a steep number, but part of that was the rate study that they did for the ordinance for wastewater and also for water. And so that has already probably been paid out of, I would assume, the wastewater. Correct? The rest of the bonding would come out of the
told, this would clarify or anything else is wastewater project. So just like water, when you do an 18 and 19 on water for SRF, it comes out of water's funds. And so in this particular, if you do water and you do two processes, that will come out of wastewater, so you have revenue, not, nothing to do with tax money at all.
Further discussion? All in favor?
Aye.
Carries. That's all of the business that we have unless there's any other business. Further knowledge? Comments?
Gail Connor, 510 East Franklin. I have a question. I did email you this. I don't know if you had time to respond with yesterday being a holiday. The recent posting of no parking signs in the 300 block of Summit Street, is that temporary or permanent?
It's always been, that side of the street's always been no parking. They adjust them so they're facing oncoming traffic. And we put the small signs so we make people aware that we, and they're all now facing oncoming traffic. It's always been that side of the street, it's always been no parking. And so that's how come we put the other signs up to make people aware of what is a problem through pickup for elementary school.
Right, I understand the reason. I just was curious because when I did look at the parking schedule, which is in our ordinance, I didn't see anything that denoted that side of the street, Summit Street.
Yeah, I didn't either. I did look at that today, and I know that it's been that way for a long time. As long as I can remember, but I don't know, it's not a part of the ordinance, so if we need to, we can, you know, put that on our plan list and do an ordinance to add it to the schedule. It's obviously not something that's going to change unless the school moves or we find a solution to the problem of the parents pulling off to pick up their kids after school. Anything else on that, Chief?
No. Okay, and I have one other question. The wooden decking that is covering the portion of the trail from Miller Park out to the railroad trestle of Blue Ridge area, how long is that anticipated to be there?
The wooden decking
that's covering
the power company, you'd have to get with Wabash Valley Power Association, and it'll be until they finish putting the poles in.
The reason I'm asking is because I remember when that was presented to the council months ago, I thought what I remembered was their initial pole was going to be on the hillside by the bridge and all that decking coming down and cut through the lines. It's quite deep decking. And where there's a handicapped parking space up there in the parking lot by the Blue Bridge, there's no way for somebody to access the trail from there because they would have to drop like a wheelchair 3 or 4 inches. So if it's going to be there for some significant amount of time, can something be done to create a ramp going down so that the trail portion is still accessible?
We can look into that. They are beginning, they've already installed the poles along quite a bit of the Hoosier parkland, and they've now dropped poles to be installed in most of those areas. So my guess is that this will happen pretty quickly, but that doesn't mean that they will remove the wooden, you know, protections, the mats as they call them. So I can follow up with their local project guy and see what they anticipated time frame is on that. And yes, I think, I know I've walked that. We certainly had a ramp that would make it possible for a wheelchair to, you know, get down without having to bump the wall.
Yeah, they graded the gravel from the parking lot to that for their equipment.
Yeah,
to
it's
travel
on the trail side.
Right.
Sure.
But then when we drop off to the east where you would then walk on towards the Blue Bridge, it's a significant drop. And I noticed the other day when we were out there, there were some elderly people that were kind of looking at it a little wary as well. And I figured before somebody gets dumped out of a wheelchair or injured, maybe something could be done.
Yeah, we'll look into that. I'll contact their their local project manager and see what solutions they can offer.
Thank you.
Any other comments?
So back to the.
Could you state your name?
Cameron Gates, 622 North Indiana Street. I spoke with a couple of representatives from the school and some residents down about the parking signs that y'all mentioned. The school has a route that they sent home with each child on the first day of school. It's pretty much a big circle. So where the signs were posted last week, that area was not on the designated route for child pickup. So I don't know if we could get the school sent at home. I don't know how we could get that out to the public. But if you follow that route, it's a pretty quick circle. So it does not affect any of the traffic that's coming from where the signs were. So
the parents are showing them about 2 o'clock.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
So then, because like Demi and Lisa Hondo on that corner, right, opposite that, and they've said for years that it's parked up in front of their house as well. So
they're going straight across.
I mean, the parents are out there really early. I mean, mostly by 2 o'clock they're already winding up in the horseshoe garden of the school.
It's an issue that we've had communications with the school about and presented some solutions that would alleviate that traffic. But so far, we have not come to resolution with the school. So my understanding is what we presented as proposal would require the teachers to stay for a few additional minutes and then we mixed it. That's what we were told in any case. So, Chief, do you have any additional information?
No, other than we, beginning the school year, we approached them with what we thought was a viable solution and all. And having the buses dismissed first and have everyone come to the back of the school and we made all the congestion there, and they didn't do that. So they were parking there in the no parking when we put those signs. We're just by doing that, we're just pushing the problem someplace else. I mean, like you said, on the side street. So until we get a solution with the school that we can all live with and all, we're just going to, those cars are just going to have to be on those side streets. And we've been up through there making sure they're not parking in alleys and this and that. But that's the thing. We just kind of have pushed it up, like we said, over by Denny Hans and on the other side street. So
hey, once the actual pickup starts, it doesn't take long.
No.
But the problem is the time prior that people are out there, and I don't know why they want to sit there that long after they do.
Well, I've been sitting up there, and like you said, once you see them start, it doesn't take very long. And I know I spoke to some of the homeowners there, and they said, you get people sitting there, and he said, it seems like they have accumulation of cigarette butts in their yards and wrappers and all that. So there's not just an easy solution, but we're just trying to get through this quick as we can and as safe as possible.
Yeah, the other issue is that as they start, coming to, around the circle to pick up the kids, they're sort of, allowing one car here and then the next car, and they're not really looking at kids who might be crossing the street. And we understand from people who were at the council meeting that certainly there was an incident where a kid almost got hit. And so that's why we're trying to do what we can to alleviate this congestion after school. At the start of school, it seems like everything goes through, but it's the parents lining up after or before school lets out. And as
say, an hour ahead in some cases or more. And they said, you know, lead their way through to pick up through the horseshoe.